We have with us Professor Kanchan. Professor Kanchan is a seasoned faculty with a teaching and counseling experience of 20 years at various academic level, right from schooling to MBA. Professor Rudra career path has been with Doon School and counseling at the Youth Center as a senior manager and psychological coach at United World School of Business. She facilitated self-development, provided self-awareness, clarified thinking processes, and helped to develop career path with the help of psychometric test. As a senior faculty, Professor Kanchan has been the teaching and mentor of BFT NMP students. She has been also guiding students across programs like MAFT NMP, MSCJ, short-term professional courses, PGDM, BMM. She teaches subjects like research methodology, advertising in contemporary society, media laws, and media economics are few of her favorite subjects. She has been the program in charge of BFT NMP for last 5 years. As a faculty, her research discourse illustrates a good number of research paper and a book titled Advertising in Contemporary Society for the final year BMM students of University of Mumbai. May I now request Professor Kanchan Luthra to present a paper.
Thank you, Professor Partha. Can I request you to please share the PPT?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, the topic that I have chosen for today's paper is also related to culture, but in a very different way. We've been listening to all the stalwarts in the evening speaking and telling us about different facets of how culture has had an impact on advertising and media in general. I would like to take you back to the past and look at how media has also been instrumental in telling us about how history is and what history is in a way that also becomes interesting and can be a very good storyteller. So the title of my paper is Lost History and Media. Can we have the next slide, please? Now, history like media also delves in storytelling. And probably it can be, I call it the richest subject because it has so many stories to tell. And stories that probably are never ending. We could go on making films, telling stories about them, and still we would have so much more to talk about. That is why I always say that history is probably the richest subject which is there. But only thing which I have found while I was growing up as a student was that we were taught history in a manner that was just documented facts. History was never made interesting to us. It was never told to us in a storytelling format, which I think probably should be there because these are some of the best stories that we can listen to. There's so much learning, there's so much message that is there in history, and strategies that we can plan, strategies that we can look for even in advertising today. So that is the reason I have chosen this subject as a subject for today's paper. And what I wanted to see was that make history interesting and history storytelling in a way with the help of documentary filmmaking so that both the academicians and scholars could learn from it, could look at different perspectives of history, and then maybe make it even more richer. We've seen that there are so many mysteries that are embroidered in our historical facts. These mysteries, some of them which have been solved, some they still remain unsolved, and some so unreal that if we look at all these facets, we might be thinking, did it really happen? I just want to give one example which I really was surprised when I heard it for the first time. I was reading through Maya culture and Maya civilization. There is a game at that time which they used to play. It was like very much the football that we have today. Only thing is, instead of the football, they used to have a human skull with which they used to play this game of football. And the winner was killed. because they thought that by killing the winner and the captain of the winning team, he would attain moksha, as we call it in Hindu mythology. So he would be relieved from the recycling of birth and death. So this is something which I was really amazed at, how this game was played. And if we look at it in today's times, I'm sure none of us would believe if that game was played today. So media, in a way, I have seen that it has always contributed to deciphering history. And in a way, what it has done is it has rewritten history all over again. Whether we talk about our own dynasty, which there is so much of gap in our own history, or we look at global history, the rewriting of history, if we look at the Indian history, I just want to give one example. I was watching a documentary on Indian history where they were talking about the Chalukya dynasty. And the way they used to make temples and the method that they were explaining in that documentary, how these temples were carved and how the marbles were carried from one place to another. It is, I think, more advanced than the technology that we use today. So that is the reason which always fascinated me. And that is the reason that I thought of writing this paper on documentary filmmaking. Can we have the next slide, please? Alice Brumby, she teaches at York St. John's University, and she's written in her article in History Today a very interesting analysis on World War I. And this article, it reveals the pain and anguish of the soldiers. And the pain and the soldiers which they have gone through, and especially when the World War I ended, we saw that a lot of people, they were celebrating that finally the war had come to an end. But the soldiers, for the soldiers, they were in a dilemma whether to celebrate or to feel sad. Captain Herman Marston, he wrote in his memoirs in 1976 a reason that why he could not write about his experiences way back when the First World War ended. And one of the major reasons that he's quoted in his memoirs is that he wanted to speak about the pain that he had gone through and also his fellow mates. But what he was not able to do it was that if he wrote about it and people read all those memoirs, the pain would again become alive, not only for the soldiers, but also for the families. And that is the reason he wrote so many years after the World War I ended. He wrote his memoirs in 1976. Can we have the next slide, please? So the objective of my paper was to find out how documentary films are instrumental in education. And I was trying to look at it from two perspectives. One, in the delivery of syllabus that we have for various subjects, and in designing new. So these are the two that I have looked at as using documentary filmmaking as a tool and as an educational aid in today's times. Can we have the next slide? The methodology that I have used method, and I wanted to find out whether documentary filmmaking can actually, in today's times, because we are using online education so much because of the COVID, documentary filmmaking can become a very important educational tool in providing education. So as I mentioned earlier, I studied this case study using two different aspects of the courses, and second, syllabus delivery. Can we have the next slide? Now, in 2008, there was a documentary film which was made, Breaking the Maya Code. This documentary traced the journey of archaeologists, linguists, mathematicians, and historians, how they understood and how they cracked the language which was spoken in Maya civilization. And this documentary has been instrumental in designing new courses for Florida University, Mississippi University, where they have started a course on Maya civilization. And one of the important aspects of this documentary was that Florida University, they started an experiment using this specific documentary, where they took the language, that is the Mayan language, back to the Mayans. Mayans, they have been residing and habitating in the area of Mexico, especially the Guatemala region. Now, what had happened after the Spanish invasion, they were forced to stop using their own language. And as a result of that, over the period of years and after generations, they had forgotten what Mayan language was. And especially even the names that they were keeping of the children and everybody else around them, they were all Christian names. So they had actually forgotten what Mayan language was. And this experiment that was conducted by Florida University, they took the Mayan language back to the people. They taught the language to them. And in a way, they provided an identity to the Mayans after almost a century. So it is as if people really got to know who they were after a century break, which had come in between. Another documentary that I want to mention, especially over here, is a documentary which is Doomsday, World War I, and another documentary, They Shall Not Grow Old. These two documentaries, they give an insight into the documentation of events. These documentations are not just historical facts, but these documentations are also talking about more of the emotional side of the soldiers, the pain that they have gone through, what they had to, the situations that they had to live in. So the emotional side of the war, which generally we don't read in history, we generally get to know the political scenario, we get to know the social scenario, the economic scenario. One aspect which is always missing is the emotional connect that we have in history. So these two documentaries, they offer, most importantly, the emotional connect that we get to have with these soldiers, what they have gone through. And then probably we can take an empathetic stance as to what would have happened during that time and what they would have gone through. So in a way, these documentaries, they help the students in critical thinking and analyzing historical events. So that is the reason I chose these two documentaries, especially in teaching of history and specifically World War I. Can we have the next slide, please? Now, basically, what I have tried to analyze and come to the conclusion through this case study is that in-depth study using documentary filmmaking, they can reveal a number of facts. And these facts, especially the emotional facts, they can enrich the subject, a subject like history, a subject like archaeology. So all these subjects, they can be enriched by using these documentary films that have been made. There are interesting and fascinating facts which academicians and scholars both can use to impart education and to imbibe education. These documentary films have shown that advanced technology, it is possible to decipher unknown facts, and it can bring them to public light for all of us to gain from. Can we have the next slide? So this brings me to the end of my paper. If there are any questions, I'll happily take them.
I think there is no question in the inbox. Okay, thank you so much, Professor Kanjal Luthra.
Just one comment, ma'am. Thank you very much. It was a wonderful paper, and I think you are dealing with something which we have been discussing, and you know, something close to my heart. Thank you very much for this paper.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much.